third Monday evening, and as our Easter festivities were coming to the end, Maria from Nicosia, you know Maria, was his mother-in-law, she came up to me and said, "Cosmas, I had a wonderful time. It was perhaps the best Easter of my life. I am proud of you guys. You did an excellent job. Your work, your efforts, the last 2 months paid off. Everybody had a great time. The food was excellent, the program, the bingo, everybody participated in our Easter games. There was a lot of fun, a lot of happiness, funny moments, and a lot of dancing. You proved that if we work hard, really hard, with passion and pertinacity, bringing together all the members of our community, supporting each other, solving problems and resolving conflicts in the way, we can achieve great things." Our success this Easter was just the beginning. They say that if you hit low, if you aim low, you hit the ground. If you aim high, you hit the target, you achieve your goals. I dare to dream big. I dare to visualize and to see our village to be the most famous village on Larnaca's highest mountains. To see our small humble village, Ayous, be a place where all the local people and foreigners would like to see. No, I don't come from Bavatsinya. No, I don't come from, my village is not near Lefkara, and we don't have a restaurant called Maria. I had enough of people confusing our village with our synonymous neighboring village called Bavatsinya. I come from Ayous. I come from Ayious. I am Ayous, you are Ayous, and we are proud of it. Yes, we are proud of it. There is an abundance of reasons and ways we can differentiate our village from the other villages in our area. Okay, we don't have Maria's restaurant from Bavatsinya, but we have Chloe's restaurant. We have Yorgo's restaurant, Paniko's restaurant. They also make very nice seasonal meze. And when it's season, they also offer andalabuya.
Wow.
And on Sunday midday, Costas, Chloe's husband, makes the most tasty finger-licking, sucking pig of chocolate under the big oak tree. Wise, of course, was telling his story with a number of divinations. We have Hermes Factory producing traditional Cyprus sweets. People can visit to try out Gligonga Redagi and Sujuko. We have our beautiful nature trails around the village. We have, we produce the best tomatoes, sweetest tomatoes, Comandaria wine. We have fresh fruits all year round. And now we are not isolated anymore. We have an efficient, a fast and safe road network that leads to our village. We have a regular bus service, and now we have the number one, the strongest tool ever. We have free high-speed internet for everybody. Our possibilities with the internet are endless. Our children can even study PhD online here with us without leaving the village. Our website is still weak. Our Facebook page needs constant updating with photos and material, and of course many likes. I don't expect you to work with the internet. You will help otherwise. But your children can do that. All the children now know how to use the internet and Facebook. So on our next meeting, I would like you to bring your children along. We're going to sit down. We're going to come up with ideas, ways with which we can improve the image of our village, ways by which we can get funds from the European Union, ways with which we can use the internet and social media to promote our village and attract more visitors. I am concerned, I am worried, I'm even sad to see that our village is slowly dying. I remember times when there were so many people in the village. The streets were full of people. There were children in the streets running up and down playing. The church was full on Sundays. Now, not even on Christmas Day, it's one third full. Do you remember, Andreas, when your wedding lasted 3 days? There were so many people in the village at that time. We're only 130 people, 130. And our number keep declining because our children leave. We have to do something about it. We have to do it now, today, and every day. We need to attract more people into the village, make our village a loving, a happy place to live, attract visitors, guests, and a nice place to live. I know you have your family to take care of. I know you have your work, and coming home at night after waking from dawn to dusk, all you have to do after dinner is go to bed and sleep and not think about your village or your wife's needs for that matter. However, if you continue to work in isolation, minding our businesses, without considering the common good and what is the best for everyone, then we're going to lose the battle. We have a choice. Either continue working, doing what we have been doing the last 20, 30 years, and end up living alone without our children because they're living in a place with houses that are falling apart, and to see our villages with mature trees die, become grassland with bushes. Or we can work together. Me, you, and all the members of our community towards a better, brighter future, full of hope and prosperity. We can do it. It can be done. We proved what we can do last Easter, and we will do it. So I'll see you next Sunday after church with your children.